Hi, I'm Matthew from OpenResty Inc. Today we will discuss how to share data across different HTTP requests served by an OpenResty application. We first prepare our test application's directory tree. The easiest way to share data among requests is to use a custom Lua module. We add a global counter variable on the top level of this module. Then we always increment this counter in a module function named main. And return the new counter value. Let's save the file and quit Vim. Now let's quickly craft the Nginx configuration file. Here we specify where to look for our Lua module. Then define a server listening on the local 8080 port. And a root location with content by Lua block. Load up our Lua module and invoke its main function. And output the returned counter value as the response body. Save the file and quit Vim. Let's check the directory tree again. Looking good. Start this OpenResty application without sudo. Here we only enable a single worker process. Send an HTTP request to the server using curl. The counter value is 1. Again. Cool, it's 2 now. It will only keep growing. This count Lua variable is shared because it is an up value of the Lua module function. And the Lua module is cached and shared in the global Lua Jeet virtual machine. See? We can also access the cached Lua module directly. The package.loaded global table holds all the loaded Lua modules. Here, most of the modules are those standard ones. There is a limitation, however. Such data cannot be shared among different Nginx worker processes. It's not a problem here because only one worker process is configured. But usually we would utilize multiple CPU cores by enabling multiple worker processes. Then each worker process would have its own counter. Let's test the configuration and then reload the server. Now we should have 4 worker processes. So this Lua module data sharing approach is mostly useful for Lua level data caching. The resty.lua-cake Lua module shipped with OpenResty is designed for such use cases. We will cover this module in a future tutorial. If we want to share data across all the worker processes, we should use the Lua shared memory dictionaries instead. We will cover this topic in another dedicated tutorial. That's all I'd like to cover today. Happy hacking! If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.